Dr. Daniel Cantor, and I'm the president of the Florida Society of Neurology and the medical director of Neurologique. I'm here once again with MS World, and we just heard a really interesting presentation about plasticity. So I have Dr. George Kraft here, who's the Alford Professor of MS Research at the University of Washington. Dr. Kraft, why is neuroplasticity so important in multiple sclerosis?
Let me tell you that I think neuroplasticity is maybe the most important thing in multiple sclerosis. Because when we think of MS, what it is really is a disease that attacks the nerves in the brain. Okay. And when something is under attack, time after time, we sometimes lose the nerves. The people with MS will lose the nerves. And if you lose the nerves in the brain, you lose part of the circuit that allows you to function, to walk, to think, to talk, to conceptualize things. But it's the wonderful news is that the body is a marvelously regenerative, has a capacity to just overcome some of those things. And most MS patients don't know it's happening, but it's happening automatically in their brain. It's like nature is the best treatment.
Okay.
And what happens, in summary, is that the connections between the nerves is what, it's like a big computer with all the connections. And the body doesn't really grow a lot of new nerves in the brain, but it can grow a tremendous number of connections. One nerve in the brain can have up to 10,000 connections with
10,000.
Other nerves. Yes. So the reserve capacity is just tremendous. And in patients, even with advanced disease, we see them functioning at a very high level, even though they've lost a substantial number of neurons in the brain.
Well, that gives us a lot of hope. Thank you so
yes,
much.
Yes, my pleasure. Thank you.